What now?
I guess you go home.
So this is it then. 2 years. 2 years. Down the drain, into the trash.
I'm sorry it had to end up this way.
You're sorry. You're sorry. You're sorry for sticking your dick into someone else behind my back? You're sorry for wasting 2 years of my goddamn life all because you fucked another guy?
Look,
you're sorry
do you
that
want
it had to end up this way?
What else do you want me to say?
You can go fuck yourself, you asshole. Because I can't forgive you for this.
I don't need your forgiveness.
Yeah? Well, I don't plan on being forgiving anyway. I just pray to God you don't even try to apologize to me again after all the shit you put me through, you scum.
You not curse at me in my own house. I won't stand for that shit.
Or what, Jared? What the fuck are you gonna do about it? I can't curse in your own home, but you're allowed to fuck another guy in the bathroom of my own home?
Look,
who the fuck do you think you are right now to tell me I can't slander your stupid self in your own stupid fucking home? No, I'm tired of looking after you. I'm tired of looking for you. I'm tired. I'm strained. I can't take it anymore.
But then why did you stay? Why did you stay with me for 2 years? No one made you stay.
You're right. No one did. But do you know why I stayed and put up with your bullshit for 2 years? It's called love. You ever heard of that word? Love? I loved you. I gave you everything I could muster up. My time, my body, my soul, my heart. And you unwrapped it and wore it on your dick and fucked the worth out of it. There's nothing left now. There's no more to it. All you could do was take. And think about yourself. You craved my attention, but you could never give it back. Why? What was it about me that you didn't like or appreciate? Was it because I waited up until the crack of dawn to make sure you'd come home safe after a night of going out? Maybe it was all the meals I'd make for you to make sure you were well fed. And healthy. Maybe that didn't mean anything at all. Or maybe it was because the sex wasn't good enough anymore.
You're right. The sex wasn't good anymore. It was terrible. You never want to have sex with me anymore, and all you do is make excuses about not wanting to clean up or being too tired.
So this is about sex. I'm sorry that you can't control your hormones. I'm sorry that my sex drive is lower than yours and that I prefer to cuddle and watch movies over being fucked to numbness. I'm sorry that it is easier for you to stick it than for me to prepare for it. And I'm sorry that I don't like the sensation of being penetrated anymore after what?
After what?
Nothing, never mind. My point being.
No, Leo, after what?
Forget it.
Is there something you want to tell me?
No, I don't have to say anything.
Tell me.
What's there to tell?
You're hiding something from me. What are you hiding?
I'm done talking to you. I'm going.
Well, you're not leaving until you tell me.
Don't! Tell me what to do! I'm not your property anymore. You can't tell
Leo,
me what to do.
Listen
get out of my way.
Listen,
Jared, get out
down.
Of my way. Jared, get out of my way.
Leo.
Jared! Jared, get out of my way!
Leo, listen. I want to know what happened. I want to listen to you. Just tell me.
Why did
Please.
You fuck Harrison?
What does he have to do
Why Harrison?
Are you supposed to be telling me something about
him?
Christ, it was convenient, I guess. He was just there.
So you went over to my house to fuck him?
No, I didn't come over to fuck him. He was just there.
So you did it anyway?
I did.
He needed to borrow one of my textbooks from my second year in college. Moons of the Solar System. It was for his astronomy class, and he didn't want to buy it or rent it. And I had the book. I invited him over to pick it up and then go. That was it. That was what was supposed to happen. He comes over at 8 p.m., about an hour before you. And I have the book ready to give to him by the front door. He asked me for a cup of water because his mouth was feeling a bit dry. So I invited him in to get something to drink. And I knew I should not have let my guard down, even for a friend of 6 years. All I remember was waking up on the kitchen floor. The water cup just broken next to me. My pants pulled down. And my legs. Everywhere was sore and numb. I couldn't speak. My throat felt tight and squeezed, but I could hear you coming in through the ringing sound in my ear. I could hear you talking to him. I could hear the lust in your voice and him telling you how I left the house to pick up some food. Why he was still there, I don't know. But all I know was that I could recognize the inflection in your voice. You two made your way into the hallway bathroom. He won't be back for a while. Trust me. He won't be back for a while. Trust me. He doesn't have to know. You didn't even bother to look. You didn't even bother to look for me to see if I was home. You let your lust cloud your thoughts. Meanwhile, I was just lying there, listening to you fucking animals gorge over each other's bodies. I picked myself up, and I limped over to the bath. I limped over to the bathroom, but no. You two were in there. So I went upstairs to my bedroom. You didn't even know that you were fucking my rapist. And that's what disgusts me. You didn't plan on fucking him? I didn't plan on getting fucked by him? But you made the choice! I didn't have a choice.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because you weren't worth anything to me anymore. I just pulled through up until now, so you can own up to your own mistakes. I wanted you to see what you have done to me.
I'm so sorry.
You two deserve each other.